Hi there. Today I thought I would bring to you what I have done for Colour Blast in the last 4 months. I've finished a full journal that's gotten quite thick. It has probably took me about 3 months or so to fill it up, so I thought I'd do a bit of a flip through for you and you can have a bit of a look and a bit of a refresher. These I got from, so don't forget to tag Colour Blast Australia, hashtag Colour Blast Australia and at Colour Blast Australia for it when you use their products so that we can always see what you're creating because we all love to do that. Follow Colour Blast on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest and YouTube. So I started off when I first got the Colour Blast products by swatching them. I did a video and a blog post on that. Carved out my own stamps and painted them on so I could see what colours they were, what the shimmers were, and just get a bit of a feel for the different products. So these are the colour shimmer spray, and on this side I've got the colour embossing powder, which at the time I had a fairly dry ink pad, so not much of it has come up. Colour shimmer cubes, which were all very nice and wrinkly. Colour shimmer dust that I wasn't aware of how to use them, and when I first put them down, put the powder down and sprayed them, they went everywhere, but I did love the change of colour, it was great. Mica powders on this page as well, and I've got some colour paste on here. One of the first pages I did was I did my eye, which was one of the things that I enjoy painting. They are all Colour Blast products except for the flesh acrylic paint around it, and I've got tissue paper underneath that to give it a bit of texture. I have a video on that as well and a blog post, so you can have a look at that. And there's a bit of texture around there with the embossing powder as well. This girl I did using the colour shimmer cubes, and then it's all Colour Blast again except for the acrylic green paint on the background. There's a blog post and a video for her on different techniques to use with watercolour to get these sort of patterns involved in her dress there. I did another swatch. Oh, this was when I did, I popped the colour shimmer sprays, colour marker powders and shimmer dust in the water brushes, and then I just painted them on to see how they turned out on there. And then I painted this girl using the water brushes filled with the Colour Blast products. So I've done a video on both those, the setup of the brushes as well as using the brushes to paint this girl. And there's a blog post in regards to that one as well. And I just love the shimmer that come out in the words there. And I can't actually remember what I used for that, but I do love it. And the colours, just the brightness of the colours are just lovely. I thought I'd try them on a black background and see how they looked. And most of them you can see. So I've got down the bottom, I've got the colour shimmer cubes, which I love them on the black background. Colour paste, colour shimmer dots at the top, colour shimmer spray, colour mica powder and colour embossing powder. So it's just playing around with them and seeing what different effects you can get and what they look like. This feather was done using all the Colour Blast products. And I've got some of the shimmer dust on the background, and then using some of those to make the feather with some embossing. But it looked a bit too close to another mixed media artist, so I haven't included that at all. And then I was invited down to demo at the World of Craft with, for Colour Blast with Tanisha, and that was the first time that I met her. And this girl here was one of the girls that I created that day. And I learned this technique of stamping with a watermark ink pad and then dusting with a paintbrush, the mica powder at the top to get the image of the stamp on it, which was new to me, and that's probably one of my favourite uses of mica powder. She was also down there at the same World of Craft show, and she was a stamp. And then when I got home, I painted in the skin colour and put a bit of texture with a stencil, and I presume that's some paste through that as well. So I really love the colours of it. They're just easy to work with. And I got some more product, did some more swatching, got colour paste, colour shimmer dust, colour mica powder, colour embossing powder, colour spray, colour shimmer spray, and colour shimmer cubes down here. And it's a quick and easy way that if I want a certain colour, I can just flip this open, have a look, and see which type of purple or blue or whatever colour I'm after. I can go pick and then go hunting through my stuff. At the expo, I created these tags as part of the demo, and I just brought them home, didn't quite know what to do with them, so I thought I might as well stick them in my art journal as part of my colour blast journey. And these are the ones I did on white. So, and that's when I fell in love with sienna on the colour paste there. It's a lovely colour, which made me create this page, which was all about sienna. So there's a video on and a blog post on this one available on YouTube and the Colour Blast website that has me using sienna in four different ways. I've used it with the shimmer spray, the colour shimmer cube, colour paste, and the colour embossing powder, as well as the black and white gesso. I think that was all that was used in that one. And it's got like so much texture. It's just, if you touch it, it's quite bumpy. This one was created for the triangle challenge that we had a few months ago, which I wasn't quite sure what to do when last week on the internet came up with this one. So I've popped the video up on that and also ended up doing the blog post, which I wasn't originally going to do. But there was just so many, I'd mixed the powders with so many different mediums, I thought it should go up there. I wasn't happy with how this girl, she was a stamp, how she turned out. So I've just, the videos in that I finished before I did her. But I've used crackle medium and gel medium and gesso, and I had washi tape on there and all sorts of different things. So you can have a look at that. Then I went to my first ever scrapbooking retreat with Colour Blast. Not that I actually scrapbook, but I thought I would go down there and see what all the fuss is about. And it was just good, nice, relaxing time. Lots of food, lots of friends, lots of laughs. It was really good. And that's when I first met the colour artisans. So this was my first swatch done with those. And then I did them on the black as well, which they didn't really work on black. And then created this girl's using mostly the colour inks. And she was a stamped image that I just made into a body. And sort of that's what I played around with those, just to get used to them a little bit. And then here I've done I mixed them in with different mediums to see what the inks would do. So I've mixed it with light modelling paste here, crackle paste, matte gel, matte medium, white heavy gesso, acrylic paint, and black heavy gesso. And then I've popped it through a stencil to see the colour changes, how runny it gets, things like that. And then along the bottom, I've just popped the medium down first, let it dry, and then painted the artist ink over the top, which for this one, it was rust that was used the whole way through. So there's a few different changes there. Probably the gel was in the modelling paste, the ones that held the colour the most. But I really like the effects of the crackle paste on there. It looked quite good. There was a challenge to use some of our little goodie bag and put up a page that could be judged by the end of the retreat. And this was as close as I got to a scrapbooking page, though I was told that if it was done in a journal, it's still not a scrapbook page. But anyway, I gave it a bit of a go. This tag was, we went to visit a local shop and we did a make and take, and this was the tag that we created using the oxide inks and some embossing and a few different things like that. So we used some triangle stamps which we were given, and the doily was part of the challenge. So it was something a little bit different. This one was I had a friend who challenged me to use a Ferris wheel. So she gave me a die cut of a Ferris wheel to use on this page, which took me a little while to get anywhere where I was kind of happy with it. And I borrowed some stamps as well of the Diane Reevely stamps. My husband's got a beard, so I thought that would be a nice little addition of there. And the sequins we got while we were at the retreat as well, so I tried to pop them in, which added a heap of texture, but obviously had to tone it down a little bit because it's like only their way to the hair. This was a video and a blog post that I've done. So I decided to give macrame a little go and see how the if we could dye the cotton with the different Colour Blast products. So this one was done with the Colour Artist ink, Colour Shimmer Dust, Colour Spray and Colour Shimmer Spray. And probably the best result was with the Artist ink that I ended up using on this one. It was the berry that I used. So it's just, you know, experimenting with what you have and seeing what you can do with it. The background of this page was the Colour Shimmer Dust Velvet. And you can just see, like, it's just got that shimmer in it. I'm not sure if you can see that on camera or not, but it's just got that little bit of glitter through it, the whole, which, yes, adds that bit of sparkle. I then did, with the colour artist thing, still mucking around with them because I love the colours so much, I did the colour mixing here. So I just added the colours together, put them in the corresponding things, and saw how many colours we could make. So this could be endless, depending on how much, what the ratio is. So there's a video and a blog post for that on how I did that. I also mucked around with the colour wheels with the different sprays to see what they did. So I might even do a video on that one day. Then we had a feather challenge. I can't remember what month that was. So I was going to put this girl in it, but I ended up changing my mind and putting a different girl in. But I did upload a video on her, I think. Yes, I did. I did do her. So she was all Colour Plus products, except for some Intense Pencil and some Crackle Paste. But other than that, that was pretty much it, and a bit of collage. I quite liked her. These were just, I was just mucking around one day, doing something a little bit not so serious. And a friend of mine suggested that these guys look like my kids, which I guess the right answer is to say that they do, and as well as hardboard lollies. But I think they turn out quite cute. This was also part of the feather challenge. I was trying to make a wing, but it didn't quite go to plan, so I just sort of moved on from that page because I just couldn't fix it, and it all got too hard, and I was getting quite frustrated, so I just moved on from that. And this is a girl that I put up for the feather challenge. So she was using all Colour Blast products as well, and I've used my favourite stamping technique with the mica powder over the top. And I thought she turned out quite well. So to see, find the those monthly challenges that Colour Blast runs, you just click on, go to Facebook and go to the Colour Blast Creative Corner page, and they're in there. It's changed every month. See what the new challenge is, and you can win a voucher of Colour Blast products. So, and we all love seeing each other's work, so it's a good idea. A bit of fun. On this page, I got some new embossing paste. So I was just trying experimenting with it and seeing how it went. The blue is just from a dirty stencil that I had, so that wasn't part of the colours at all. So that's the embossing paste. And then I added in some embossing powder, which was the lipstick, and it became quite grainy there. This one was Colour Mica Powder Watermelon, which I thought turned out quite nicely. And there was a Colour Shimmer Dust for Lollipop, which I probably added a little bit too much dust in there, but it was quite a strong colour. This one, I just popped the paste down first, let it dry, and then put the Colour Artist ink, Colour Spray, Colour Shimmer Spray, and Shimmer Cube over the top, and they turned out quite well as well. All these ones that were left over, I also popped them in moulds as well and made like little faces out of them, which I have used for something else which I don't have with me at the moment. But here I realised I was getting to the end of my journal, which I then get a bit impatient with and just want to get it finished. So I was just doing some quick things. So just mostly using sprays through stencils and mucking around with that a little bit. This was a mandala that didn't quite go to plan either, and I got quite frustrated with it, couldn't quite get it to where I wanted it, and just turned the page to move on. This girl was using the water brushes that I had of the Colour Blast products in there with the Colour Paste Bling through a stencil. And if you find that the Colour Paste or any other products are getting a bit sticky in your journal and they're getting stuck together, like this has got stuck in her hair and ripped a bit of her hair out, just wax it. So you just add a little bit of wax and let it dry for, you know, about a day or so, and it loses that most of that stickiness. I think there was a lot of leftover paint on this page, which I then probably gessoed over and used some sprays and got this guild sorted. Can't quite remember what I used in some of these products. So that was just messing around with some sprays as well and some stencils, and oh, I love my drips, so I try and get drips in all the time. I can't remember what I used on this page. I think that it was either gesso or it was I think it was black gesso, and I also added in some colour artist ink and the background. I can't quite remember what I used on there. And then I got some new stencils that I'm trying to get sorted, and so I was just mucking around with those and using the different colours in there and just putting the paste in and then scratching into them to try and get some patterns happening. And I love the Colour Blast products on black, a lot of black background. I think you just, the colour is awesome and you get that really nice shine and bling and shimmer to them. So and that's the end of that. I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope you go back and find what you want to watch and go find some other ones and have a look at the other videos that I've done in the past. And until next time, thank you.